Yeah, come.
How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Thank you very much for your presence, even via Skype with us today in this railway forum where we host many people interested in how the Greek railway will upgrade its functions and will attract more and more investments. We would ask you to comment on that and, of course, last but not least, ask you to tell us a little more about the Shift to Rail initiative and how this initiative can be useful also to this effort of the Greek railway today.
Okay, thank you very much for these opportunities. Apologies for not being there with you today, but unfortunately I had previous commitments here in Brussels, and I think use of technology is also part of what we are trying to do in the context of Shift to Rail. So to make use of technologies to put together people, business and regions. So if you allow me, I will speak about Shift to Rail to give you a bit of framework, and after I will mention also how Shift to Rail can help in developing future and upgrading future or existing railway system. So as you know, Shift to Rail is a public-private partnership. So it's a joint venture between the European Union and the private sector. The private sector is representing the industry, the railway industry at large, including the manufacturer, the railway undertakings, the network managers, but also small medium enterprises, I would say research centers, university, coming from all parts of Europe, and the industry is investing in the Shift to Rail program 1 billion euros, a bit less, but all in all 1 billion euros of research and innovation activities, and Shift to Rail against these 1 billion euros co-fund in accordance with the rule of Horizon 2020 the maximum amount of 450 million euros. So for each 2 euros invested by the industry in research and innovation, there is 1 euro invested by the union to support this type of investment. Why joint undertaking? Because it's a risk-sharing facility. So we ask the sector to invest more in research innovation to address societal challenges that are affecting our society. So in Shift to Rail, we are developing railway innovative solutions to contribute to address societal challenges coming from climate change, from environmental impact, from growth, from jobs, from competitiveness of the European industry. So we are going well beyond the railway system, but we consider that the railway system is the backbone of transport, and transport is really the backbone of the economy and of the society. So this is the overall background. So how we arrive to deliver this this program is through different innovation programs that are tackling all the subsystems. They are tackling the infrastructure, they are tackling the ERTMS, so the signalization and communication, the rolling stocks, and the freight. And we have one federating IP that is dedicated to the passenger experience. So the Shift to Rail is really the instrument that has the objective to bring and modernize and to bring back to the future the railway system. And as much as we have extreme high level innovation, for example, we have in 40% of the towns around Europe automated metro system. So we are much more advanced, for example, compared to the automotive sector. At the same time, on the main line, on the regional line, on the I would say rural line, the operation are still coming from technologies of the past.
Do you think that specifically the Greek railway is ready to take advantage of all this effort you have just described to us?
I believe that any railway around Europe can benefit from the solution are coming from shift to rail. I believe that the railway system in Greece should benefit from it. We need also to be realistic. What we are developing at the moment is research innovation. We plan to start to reach demonstration activities in different environment in the period of 2020 and onwards. So I believe that it's possible to bring some solution to the market. Also in Greece, and to be sure that also Greece benefit from this type of investment that is done by the European Union. And this investment is really tackling how the operations are managed, and that's really the objective to bring two new technologies to the market. So information to the passenger, new trains that are lighter, more efficient, that are capable to manage in a better manner the energy consumption. New braking system, a new revised infrastructure that is more resilient, anticipation and predictive maintenance in order to reduce the cost of the infrastructure, the introduction of ERTMS as much as possible to ensure interoperability, not only for the interest of interoperability, but also for the interest of business case. For example, has been demonstrated that the introduction of the ERTMS that has maybe a high level investment at the beginning has a much lower cost in the maintenance later on, up to maybe 30-40%. For example, global positioning that will require in the future not making use of infrastructure on the ground, but will be mostly substituted by virtual components and digital components. I think all these components are available to be later on deployed by any operator, by any infrastructure manager, with the objective to reduce the cost of operation, to make railway more attractive, and to keep industry competitiveness. So I believe that, and I think Greece is also strategically positioned in connecting north-south and east-west. So I think it's really important that also the Greek network will benefit from the technologies that are coming up from shift to rail in order to leverage, to upgrade on one side the infrastructure, but also to leverage the existing infrastructure upgraded to make a better use of it.
Do you believe that investing in the Hellenic, in the Greek railway, is this an interesting scenario for a European investor?
I believe that if we look at the evolution of our society, where we will have more and more people moving from the outside of the big towns to the inland, to the inside of big towns, and more and more people being mobile, I believe that the railway system is the only one capable to manage as the number of people that we are talking about. And I believe that this can be an opportunity for investors to look in the long-term perspective. This can be a way, a possibility for investors, for example, that have a perspective on 30 plus year with a stable return on investment that are looking for supporting also the Greek economy.
We have a last question for you. As an Italian, very charming one, how do you think this cooperation between Trenitalia and the Greek Trenose will go?
Well, I hope very well, because Trenitalia and the group Ferrovie dello Stato is working together in Shift to Rail on different type of projects. So I believe that also this cooperation shall benefit of the work and the investment done by Trenitalia within Shift to Rail. And I hope that any type of collaboration will be upgrade of the Greek railway system will benefit also from this type of cooperation and this type of demonstration. One of the key components that we want to see is to use the existing network to demonstrate the new innovation, the innovation coming from Ship to Rail. So if also this cooperation between Italian and Greek is facilitating this work, will be excellent.
So you believe that Trenitalia is going to heavily invest in the Greek railway?
I cannot say this. I'm far away from this, but I believe that if they express their interest in this direction, I believe there is an underpinning business case justifying the decision they took.
Thank you very much for being with us today, for all the interesting information you shared with us, and we will come back to you with our conclusions, also edited in English, so that the members of the Shift Rail invitation could also share these conclusions with us. Thank you very much again.
Thank you. Thank you. Have a nice conference. Bye-bye.